Oh no, the enemy ships are here. Don't worry, our super turret is gonna take care of them. Nope, that's not how it works. Alright, so if you watch my critical ship reviews, you know that I'm very much against custom turrets. Now, obviously, if you make custom turrets just for fun, that's fine. I'm talking about survival use cases here. So, I think I've explained enough why custom turrets are generally not a good idea for survival ships in my critical ship review videos. But just to solidify that understanding even more, I'm gonna explain why that's the case real quick here. So, what you need for a custom turret? You need the custom turret controller, then you need the camera, then you need the rotor, the hinge, then finally you get to the weapons bit. But at this point, the turret is already very expensive. Not to mention, you will have to put armor. So, all of that, all of these things over here, you can get all of them from a single turret that is way cheaper and more stable. It doesn't clang as much and all that stuff. You can actually save PCU from a custom turret because a single barrel of this costs 80 PCU, and for two barrel turrets, you get to use 275 PCU. So technically, even with all those prerequisite for a custom turret, if you just put a lot of barrels on a custom turret, then eventually you will get to a point where you will save PCU compared to using normal turret. Like, you will get more barrels for the same amount of PCU. But then you will end up with something like this. I mean, sure, you might be saving PCU at this point, and maybe you can even make it stronger than normal turret by making it have more armor. But at this point, on top of already existing risk of clanging, this is highly impractical. And you will be centralizing a lot of your weapons at a single point. So you get what I'm saying, right? This is just highly impractical and it's not reliable. While you can get better performance and more convenience from default turrets. But alright, with a custom turret, you can use small grid weapons, right? I mean, that's even worse in terms of PCU to damage ratio or damage per PCU ratio. I mean, sure, it looks cool, but it's neither practical nor efficient. The only practical use case for a custom turret that I can think of is railgun custom turret for leggy people. So, if you're leggy or have high ping in survival multiplayer servers, it's gonna be really hard to hit your target using manual aiming, even with the target lock system. That's the reason why the person who challenged me a bit ago didn't do the battle with me, because he was really lagging, and that wouldn't have been a fair battle. So, that's pretty much the only practical use case scenario of a custom turret that I can think of. And that's why custom turrets are a bad idea most of the time. But if you feel like you know more about practical reasons to use custom turrets in survival scenarios that I haven't mentioned, then feel free to tell everyone in the comment section below.